And here I am at South By, and I am interviewing a very amazing man. He's doing really cool things with social media. So tell me, what are you up to?
Well, my name is Chris Noble, and we're up to a lot. The company's called Cause Media Group, and we run social campaigns that integrate celebrities, charities, and brands so that everybody wins. That's what we do. I'll give you a quick example of that. We actually just won the Mashable Award for most creative social good campaign of 2010 for our work on Twit Change, which had 180 celebrities auctioning off their social capital. The celebrity will retweet or mention you. They'll follow you for 30 days. 180 celebrities raised over $600,000 just, you know, having Eva Longoria or Alyssa Milano follow you for a month and retweet what you're saying.
That is very cool.
It's great. I mean, the celebrities didn't, all the celebrities had to do was engage in the social world and make the offer. We ran the entire auction on eBay and are fulfilling those experiences and packages as we go along.
Nice.
And the charity was a Haiti relief fund.
Great.
And again, 10-day campaign, $600,000. It's a really great job.
That's cool. So it's a pretty small company, right? You were telling me 25 people?
Yeah, we're about 25, 30 people. We have sister agencies, so we burst up to 45, 50 when we need to.
Got it.
But last year we raised about $10 million, a little over $10 million for charity.
Nice.
And we did it with brands like Electrolux, Frigidaire. We helped on the Pepsi Refresh campaign a little bit.
Yeah.
We're the guys that basically work behind the scenes to make sure the digital presence works, that the cause is integrated in a transparent way, but also in a genuine way, and that the celebrity and the brand get the PR bump that they're looking for.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
Like I said, it's a fun job.
And so you're using, it's an unusual combination of brand, of celebrity, and of really changing the world. And I think that that's one of the unusual things about social media. I mean, it's really transforming business, it's transforming government, it's transforming education, just by the mere fact that it's now a transparent kind of communication. It's no longer top-down, you know, leadership telling employees or students what will be. It's the voice of the little people saying what is. Right, so there is that kind of change.
That's
but
right.
The other kind of change is the ability to aggregate, you know, like micro relief or micro funding for a charity where people can give $5 or $10 and actually really change the world. That's what I think is really, this is the other kind of change that, I mean, I'm kind of a change agent, so I'm really fascinated by that you took up this cause and you took social media in this direction.
Oh, well, thanks very much. Yeah, if you look at it, there are 1.4 million nonprofits in the U.S., right? And how many can you name, right? Can you name more than 20?
No.
Probably not.
No.
So it's a classic long tail, right? There are niche nonprofits in small communities that are serving important things in their community, but who are never going to grow beyond that community, don't have million-dollar budgets, don't have $10 million budgets.
Right.
Right? But they need, you know, really thousands of dollars, some of them hundreds of dollars, to make an impact in a really tight local circle.
Yep.
And social media enables that. You know, that's actually one of the things we really enjoyed with working on Pepsi Refresh campaign or things like the Case Foundation Giving Challenge, things like that.
Yeah.
Even new companies like Kickstarter, right? Mm-hmm. You can have a project that's important to a small group of people, and you can get it funded by pulling an audience together from just a handful of people who care about something. That's always been true, but with social media, it's a lot easier, right?
It's a lot easier.
Margaret Mead, right?
Yes.
Margaret Mead says, right, small group of people can, you know, committed with high energy, can get anything done.
Yeah.
That shouldn't exactly say that, but that's the gist.
Yeah.
And that's always been true. But now that small, passionate group of people can rally through social media, and the barrier to entry is a lot lower. That's what we're seeing. That's what Cause Media tries to tap into, to kind of keep that barrier to entry low to the causes, while still giving brand leverage to the brands that want to sponsor things, and bring the celebrities in, because face it, even local celebrities, like your TV weatherman, right?
Yeah.
Can shine a spotlight on something if they want to.
Right. So how do we find out more information about what you do and if people want to get involved?
If they want to get involved, the best thing to do is to go to our main website, which is causemediagroup.com, all one word.
Okay.
You'll see a couple different divisions there, a couple different things that we do. If you want to just learn about these kind of the intersection of cause and brand and read our blog, the blog's called whatgives.com.
Okay.
It's actually a lot easier to spell.
Right.
But so the blog really chronicles what nonprofits need to do to tell better stories, what brands are supporting nonprofits, how celebrities fall into the mix. It really covers the whole space, not just campaigns that we're running. So whatgives.com is probably the first place to send you.
Okay.
If you want to work with us, causemediagroup.com, we'd love to have you.
All right, thank you.
Thanks so much.
All righty.